I will speak about sustainable entrepreneurship, which is, I think, a compliment which has been raised now. And I take 4 points. The first one is the relation of sustainable entrepreneurship and democracy. The second is I will refer to some aspects of the SDGs. And then I go in some detail, but not very far, what sustainable entrepreneurship has to be in the context of human capital, productive capital, and financial capital. And finally, I will refer again to democracy, because I think what democracy connects with all activities in the society is that people have to be active, active based on their values they have. So, to the first point, traditional entrepreneurship concentrates on the quantitative combination of financial, productive, and human capital, and optimize the return on capital and human capital, and its remuneration is just a residuum. This is the rest. In contrast, sustainable entrepreneurship has to include the societal dimensions of capital inputs, refer to the limits all over the world and also locally, and activate the human potentials to increase distribute more equal the societal wealth. So such a turn from capital-centered to human-centered entrepreneurship needs a activation of the whole population. So what is needed is an entrepreneurship of the large population, and everybody has to be included because everybody is active in some sense according to its surrounding, and through the interconnectivity of each person to the society, it contributes to societal wealth. On the institutional level, we can distinguish between private households, private firms, and public governance as the main potential actors for sustainable development. Sustainable consumption, wealth creation by firms, and public policy depends on a multi-dimensional entrepreneurial behavior, which combines, and this is more or less the definition of entrepreneurship, it combines creative thoughts and leadership in action to enlarge the role of the individual freedom. So entrepreneurship is intimately connected to the main target of what the World Academy has adopted in Cadmus Journal and many other publications. So this role of an active society has to be seen in the context of the development of the global whole through the interconnectivities, which is more than the sum of individual activities, and also more than the sum of the three main actors, private households, private firms, and public policy. Therefore, because it's more than the sum of the individual output, the total wealth of the society belongs to the society and not for an individual institution or an individual person. This implies a responsibility of all those who use wealth for acting in the society and creating further wealth. Therefore, the society delivers capital to private firms, who are just trustees of societal wealth. They are not owner. The owner is the society of societal wealth. And firms are just trustees to manage it, and they have a vicarious role for the social demands. It is an inversion of the traditional perspective of entrepreneurship. And during the transition, wealth creation may deviate from the preferences of the consumers or distort public policy, and an active, sustainable entrepreneurial behavior of private firms as well as public policy, and each individual has to correct these deviations from currently dominant activities and distortions of the societal wealth. So this needs a cooperative behavior in contrast to the actual competition of the societal networks of human capital, financial capital, and productive capitals, which are not a quantity, but they are networks, interrelated networks, and especially financial capital can enlarge the total wealth of society, but it can be also through substitution of natural capital by man-made capital, so we can enlarge the possibilities of wealth creation as a whole. Traditionally, we think that entrepreneurship contributes to economic growth, and economic growth is sometimes considered, still considered, as an augmentation of the societal wealth. In contrast, sustainable entrepreneurship of all involved people has to change this interrelation of the capital networks, and all this needs more human capital. So, turning from traditional entrepreneurship to sustainable entrepreneurship creates employment. More employment at every level, because each decision is only possible through an input, an additional input of a human capital. And this is directly linked to the democracy. Everybody who turns from prevailing economic growth to sustainable development increases more human capital, and at the same time it contributes also to the democracy, because in every institution and in every coin of the society, the humans are active, employment increases, and this is nothing else but that what we say the Anthropocene is producing the society and its development. So, democracy is a precondition and also a result of all sustainable entrepreneurship. So I will shortly refer to SDGs, because we know SDGs. In the first presentation it was elucidated, changes the whole structure of wealth creation in the society, globally and locally. And this implies that it is needed a very important transfer of capital to every area in the world. And If we want to give money for this, this should be combined with entrepreneurial behavior of those who receive the money. Bringing water to a thirsty horse has no effect. It has to drink it for winning the race. So sustainable development is bound to an entrepreneurship in those receiving additional money coming out from new currencies or taxation of financial capital and so on. So this might be a result that the return on capital is not anymore the target, and introducing money to, for example, developing country is bound to the well-being of them, and well-being has to guide the allocation of all financial means which are collected mainly in the industrial countries. So this means we have to face that the return on capital which we transfer to underdeveloped areas has to be decoupled from the return on capital. Social capital has priority over financial capital, productive capital, and so on. So one example is the Marshall Plan. You know, after the Second World War, the Marshall Plan was very successful in both countries, American and European countries, and it was derived from the interaction of democratic societies and a large amount of human capital. So to transfer in the global Marshall Plan financial means to the underdeveloped countries or less developed countries needs an augmentation of human capital, which means in this case primarily human capital oriented towards sustainable entrepreneurship. It is not enough to educate people in the less developed countries. They have to have the capacity to implement sustainable entrepreneurship and firms which create well-being in those countries. So in all, education for entrepreneurship is a very important part within all our overall education. Education is very important in all areas. But the dimension of entrepreneurship is crucial for the sustainable, for the SDG implementation. So I cannot refer to more detailed questions. In any case, we have to recognize that many transfers to the developing countries, they are channeled in corruptive areas and not for productive use. It is only sustainable entrepreneurship in the sense that they are just trustees which can bring a global, more equal societal development. Thank you. Thank you.